Welcome back again. This is Neil with Real Terrain Hobbies, and we're continuing on with the construction of our wizard tower. If you haven't seen the first video yet, we built the foundation of a treacherous stone monolith for the wizard tower to be seated upon. And if you haven't seen that already, go and check that out first. It's in the link just above before you continue on with the video here. So now in this video, we're going to continue on with the build and make the transformation of our rock base from a white plastered sculpt to the living, foreboding cliffs of solid rock our adventurers have contended in order to approach the ever-powerful and reclusive wizard known to the area. So in case you haven't guessed it yet, part two of our Wizard Tower series is going to be painting the stone monolith our Wizard Tower is going to be seated on. And starting off, I used a light gray wash, and I did that as a fairly light color. I didn't want my rocks being too dark, and I left a few patches here and there just completely white and bare. And over top of the light gray, I went with a light brown. And these are going to be our two base colors for the overall stone look that we're going for. I'm painting the base of the structure with a gray blue tinted with a small amount of black. And this is to simulate the high tide of the base structure. It's going to be underwater for a time, and all the algae and seaweed and moss and whatnot is going to be growing on there, so it's going to be discolored. And we're going to be needing to use some olive green next in there to get that algae look. I'm using an airbrush for this, but you don't have to use that. You could do a wash if you wanted as well. And finally, I decided to go with a pale blue on the rocks as a final layer. I felt that this added a little bit extra. It's the reflection of the pale blue water onto the rocks, and it just made the rocks pop just a little bit more. And after the airbrushing was complete, I went with a light black wash, adding a few drops of black paint into about 3 or 4 tablespoons of water. And it's up to you on how dark you want to go. You can do a little bit of a test piece first beforehand just to see how dark you want it. And next, I wanted to add a dry salt effect onto the top of the waterline to simulate kind of where the waterline has dried and some salt has gathered across there, just for a little extra bit of realism. And to do this, I did dry brushing / stippling. And to dry brush, you get a bit of paint on the end of your brush. You wipe it off until only a little bit is left on there. And you kind of brush it around, kind of punch into the model. I recommend using a stiff brush, which I switched to in a second here. And then you sort of jab it in there, here and there, and it adds a stippled effect. And I found this worked excellent for a dried salt look. Next, it's time to paint all the nooks and crannies within the rocks and add the shadow and depth and stain to all of those. And to do that, we're going to be using a very heavy black wash in the darkest kind of areas that you want. And I wanted the darkest areas to be where the most water would be collecting, say, from the rain and things like that. I wanted a stained look where you get a kind of a mold that would grow and then die, and you have that black kind of stained look from where water typically runs down. And so I wanted that in the deep cracks and kind of where I felt that the water would flow through and down kind of as it went to the ocean below. So to do this with a lot of control with the paint, start out with the dark, very heavy wash inside the cracks. And then from there, I'll take my brush and dip it into water and just sort of spread along the edges of that dark paint. Otherwise, you're going to get some very heavy lines from the dark wash where it has rested and touched. You want to spread that with some diluted water on the tip of your brush, and that'll give a more natural flow and give you more control with the paint. Another technique I use for shading the different areas is to get most of the wash that's on your brush into the darker areas, the areas that you want the darkest, kind of spread it along, and as you're spreading it down, you're losing paint off your brush, you're losing the wash, and then you take that brush with less pigment and less paint and go back to the edges of the heavier areas and sort of spread it and feather it out, and that'll get those nice gradual lines and get rid of the kind of the dark contrast between where you just laid the wash and where the area is bare still. Moving on, it's time to add rocks into the ocean area that are going to be kind of poking through and creating the rough water of our ocean area. And so there's no kind of science to this. Just do whatever you think looks good. Arrange them in certain ways that it's not too cluttered and looks fairly natural. Then we'll go ahead and glue those into place. For these rocks here, I went with a straight olive green wash, and it looks quite different from the base of the structure itself, but I'm going to be adding a pale blue color onto this with the airbrush, and it's going to blend in just nicely. And for the ocean base, I'm starting off by doing a black base coat on this. I'm just using cheap black craft paints that you get at any arts and crafts store, watering it down and just brushing that on to cover the entire surface area. Now it's time to add some depth to our ocean, and to do that we're going to add some colors. So I've got a brilliant blue combined with a small amount of ivory black, and water that down. And this is going to be the deep end. It's going to be a darker blue, and we're gradually going to end up going into a light kind of pale blue at the far end. Next, I'm going to be painting the transition point between the dark, deeper area to the shallow, light area of the board. And this is the midway point. I'm going to be using a blue from Vallejo for the airbrush. And I'm using the airbrush just to get that nice blend. You can get that with an airbrush, and you can't do that quite as well with a paintbrush. So that's why I'm using the airbrush for this part, and it does it quite nicely and quite easily. And into the shallow end, I went with the pale blue. Now, at this point, you might be asking yourself why I left all those gaps under those rocks. At first, I thought it wouldn't be a big deal and it wouldn't be noticeable. Then I was thinking afterwards that it probably will be very noticeable through the resin when the water effects are actually laid down. So I decided once I had painted already that I'm actually going to change it, and I'm going to add some sand. So I'm using this decor sand from an arts and crafts store just to fill in all the gaps. And once I've got all that in place, I use some watered down PVA to spray that on and let that harden up, and then repaint over top of that. Of course, first after having added some gravel to the scene. And as a final step, all that's left to do is add some touch-ups here and there with the black wash on the steps and various other areas that you think could use some extra depth. And after that, be sure to spray your model down with some watered-down PVA or a varnish, something to protect that paint. I did do that with this one, but I didn't end up filming it. Well, I should have filmed it, but that's an important step just to protect that paint job. So that's a wrap for this video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to stay tuned for the next one. It's going to be the water effects, and those water effects are insane. It's amazing what I was able to kind of figure out with resin and how to get those waves in there, get that foam look, and do some really pretty amazing things that I haven't seen done from anyone else. So you are not going to want to miss that one. I'm going to shoot for 2 weeks faster than this one. Sorry, this ended up being 3 weeks. It should not have ended up being that long, but 2 weeks for the next video. I'm pushing for it and I know I can do it, so that's what I'm going to do. So until then, I will see you on the next one.